Act 22, the Commonwealth Charter School Law, will be 20 years old on June 19. And a lot of things have changed since 1997. When Act 22 was passed, back then there was a Clinton in the White House. Seinfeld was still on TV, and charter schools and the concept of virtual learning in general were relatively new. Cyber charters were hardly a gleam in anyone's eyes. In the 20 years since, all that has changed. Cyber charters have grown to be a major part of the charter industry, yet our own reimbursement formula for cyber charters has not changed. It is still based on the cost of a brick-and-mortar education. Right now, families are able to choose a cyber charter program that costs Pennsylvania taxpayers dramatically more than a comparable or even higher quality cyber program in the local school district or intermediate unit. On average, statewide, cyber charter education is costing the taxpayer nearly $14,000 for a regular education student, and almost $20,000, in some cases much more, for a special education student. But at the local or IU level, these costs are approaching somewhere between $5,000 and $6,000. Some cyber charter schools are even approaching the intermediate units now to contract for their services. But the cyber charter school is still being reimbursed with taxpayer dollars at a level comparable to a brick and mortar education. There's a lot of love in the halls up here in Harrisburg for free market, a system in which the prices for goods and services are determined by the open market and consumers. Competition, they say, lowers cost. Well, in this case, it's the exact opposite. The alternative choice, the cyber charter, statewide cyber charter school, is charging the taxpayers of Pennsylvania significantly more than local school districts or the intermediate units can providing the same and better quality education. Remember that when Act 22 was passed, it was sold on the idea that charters would be bringing back new innovative ideas for improvement in our regular public schools. Well, here is a success story, one could say, because the statewide cyber schools have now been copied by the districts and in the IUs very successfully. And in fact, they have improved on them very significantly. It doesn't make sense to pay more for less, yet that is exactly what we're doing here in Pennsylvania, and the taxpayers are being forced to do. House Bill 1206 would cap the amount of funding unaffiliated cyber charter schools or the statewide charter schools receive for students who live in an area in which the state district, the school district, or an intermediate unit operates its own cyber charter program. The unaffiliated cyber charter school would receive either the per student funding amount of the school district cyber school program or the intermediate cyber school program, whichever figure is higher. We grant them that. What would this save? In school year 2014-15, there were 36,000 students enrolled in 14 cyber schools with 6,800 identified students as special needs. The fiscal impact of this legislation could eventually return the entire sum of over $300 million to our local school districts statewide. We estimate that the initial savings in the first year could be as much as $50 million, half of that going to the city of Philadelphia alone. It's fair, it's common sense, and it saves taxpayer dollars. With Philadelphia's, or Pennsylvania's rather, budget crunch threatening every school budget, it's past time to correct this shameful waste of money and help solve the budget situation.